Hotep, Hotep, Haru, I want to welcome y'all all to me, to Cosmo Kid. I'm Tahir Haru Young. I will be giving out, talking about tonight. I want to talk about the Cosmo deities. I want to talk about the Cosmic Mother, really. I'm going to talk about the Cosmic Mother to y'all tonight. Let me try to get these cameras like set a little better. That way I can talk to both cameras at the same time. I don't have four up today, family. How y'all doing out there tonight? How y'all doing, family? Yeah, I'm coming with with the Cosmo information. Cosmos. But first, I would like to give a shout out. Yes, first I would like to give a shout out to Chris Cyphers, Brother Chantez, Nikki C. That's my nut. And my Asar is Chris Cyphers. My Anubis, that's Brother Cook. My Mo'at is my Satori Love. My Star, Nikaylee. Kirk Jr., the captain of the ship. Mind's Eyes. You know, name already fit you, Mind's Eyes. I want to say Hotep and Haru to Brother Chantez, to Huey P, to Kirk Jr., K. Smith. I'm trying to think of everybody. God is Supreme. Yes, God is Supreme. I'm gonna think of everybody. I'm gonna think of everybody. Dojo the Great. I wanna give you a shout out. I wanna give a shout out to let me see. Red X, I ain't forget you, Red X tonight. Noon, Atom, Amen. That's our army. Let me see. Oreo. That's my headset suit. That's headset suit. Yeah, she was buried. She was the queen, that the goddess that was buried with all the kings of all kings. But I'm be giving out information today, family, about the Cosmo Mother, the Cosmo deity of the Mother, which we would call her Nut. So, and I hope I ain't forget no shout my soul family out. I hope I didn't forget you, soul family. Somebody, I hope I didn't forget nobody. And if I did, Ty, I ain't mean to forget y'all, baby. You know, I'm gonna think of how I'm gonna I'm gonna think of some more names here as I go along. But first, let me turn the light down a little bit. Maybe y'all can see my screen a little better. That's in back of me. Until I learn how to work this YouTube. When I learn how to work this YouTube, baby, I can do this a little better. But right now, I'm going to share my screen. So I'm going to put y'all a little closer, and I'm going to share my screen. How y'all doing out there, my YouTube family, my Facebook family? How y'all doing? Thank y'all for that love. Y'all can go over there and subscribe to my YouTube page, Facebook, my Facebook family. It's Tahir Haru Young. And let me put this up. Okay. Let me see, can I bring y'all closer to me? How you doing, Elle? Shout out to you, baby. Oh, I forgot that big old speaker down there. Trying to get y'all closer to my screen. Turn that light on. Yeah, turn it all the way up. Did that make it better, family? I hope that light made it a little better so I can share my screen with y'all. Okay, y'all see here? Y'all see her? And that say, in the beginning, God said, let there be light. All right, fam? Y'all see that? In the beginning, God said, let there be light. Okay? In the beginning of that book. In the beginning of the Bible, all right? They're not talking about human people, actually. They're talking about cosmo deities, okay? And they're talking about the womb, the woman. They're talking about Nut, okay? This light is distracting me, burning my eyes. Okay, they're talking about Nut, okay? So, if y'all see here, if y'all look in and take a look at Genesis, in Genesis it say in the beginning, okay? Just them three words alone, family. Them three words alone means space, matter, and time, okay? So in the beginning, you were in the space of your mother's womb, okay? That what it means, in the beginning, okay? The matter were you, okay? You was the matter, okay? That melon. Okay, that matter. Okay, that 666, that matters. Okay, that matters. Okay, that was 666. That six melon, 60 electrons and 6 neutrons. Okay, family. Melon, people, our body works just like the universe. Exactly like the universe. Okay, so what y'all be reading in the Bibles, the Qurans, when you reading in spreads, it's talking about Allah. And Allah means womb. Everything y'all read in religion is talking about the woman. Okay, it's talking about the woman, family. It's not talking about what y'all think a man. No. Okay, so if y'all take a look at my screen right here, this talking about in the beginning there was light. So on the first day there was light. Okay, when it started talking about creation in the Bible, it started talking about creation. The first day there were light. Okay, on the second day, in the third day, he was still creating. So on the fourth day, there was another light. What light y'all think that light was? That on the fourth day, not the third day, the light rose on the fourth day. Okay, family, the light on the fourth day, not the third day, as y'all was taught. Okay, if you read your Bible correctly, y'all know that it say on the fourth day, another source of light. That other source of light was Ray, okay, was the sun, okay, that came up, Okay, so what we have in there, right now, if you put that into human life, family, you will see that that is the mother we're talking about right now in the child. Okay, we're talking about the moon, and we're also talking about the star right now. Okay, so in the beginning, you had the mother and that withheld child for 9 months in her womb. Okay, so when they're talking about the firman, when you go and read down a little further, you're going to see they're talking about the firman. The firman they're talking about was the mother of the womb. You was in that incubator for 9 months. Okay, so if y'all see my next slide. That's even in your Bible that you are gods. You are gods in the Bible. You are gods. In Psalms 82. Yeah. Look at Psalms 82. You'll show that ye are gods. Y'all are gods. Okay. Y'all see that? Can y'all see that picture? Y'all see that picture of Hector? That's it, Habru. Okay. This meaning, y'all see this, family? This meaning, the spreading of the lady's legs, of the melon lady. This the spreading of the melon lady's leg. This representing birth, family. They always represent the sun on their head. And reading up in here is her name. And this is Heharu. She has seven different deities. She have seven different deities. Okay, that's in her. She's Heharu. Her her day is Friday. Okay, her day is Friday. And that chakra color would be green on Heharu. This how we used to give birth. If y'all can see this on my live stream over here. If y'all can see that. My bad. Philly the bold bear. But yeah. That's showing how we gave birth. Okay. You see her squatting outside into the sun, not into radiation light. That's how we gave birth. These are the markings I've been telling y'all about that's in y'all hands. The M that's in your hand, and the X, and the K, and the Y, the A. This is the sun coming up out of his mother nut, coming up out of the universe. This is Sasar. If you see, you can see a X on Sasar, and you can see him really dark. Man, he's a really dark. Okay, he also would be Set right here. He representing dark time and light time. This X right here, family, they always represent the X, and it meaning like the X planet. It also means resurrect. You see, as the this also represents the navel cord going to your mother to get fed. This also represents the resurrection. Okay, not when you pass away and you think you're going to just rise back up. No. This is resurrection of the melon man's obelisk. You can also call that a penis. Okay, so this is resurrection for y'all every morning at sunrise with a set. That's what it does. Okay, on the melon man. Okay, this picture right here is showing that how you is in the womb with your mother for 9 months. All right, fam? That's what that's showing right there. And nine is the only number that you can, multiply by other numbers. And number nine is the highest number in numerology. This is the DNA, and this is getting programmed when you caught up in the web. And remember, I'll be talking about the number 8. This is also representing the Kundalini, and it also represents the DNA. It represents the cobra, the two snakes. This represents the cobra, the snake that's going through the to hit the pineal gland, the pineal gland. And it sits right here in the middle of the forehead, right here. So right here, that you good. Okay, this is one of like kind of sort of like one of the motherships that they have, but it really look like the sun. The motherships look like suns and stars and stuff, and diamonds, eggs. They have sort of they got a lot of different looks with the motherships. Okay, these are all different parts of hitting the chakras. These are the chakra codes on the body. So when it's hitting that, the chakras. Okay, my babies, I'm gonna set this phone down so I could talk a little more. Hopefully y'all can see this screen. Let me get all better. How y'all doing? How y'all doing, babies? Y'all out there? Y'all all right? Hey, my YouTube family, my Facebook family. I'm tired here, Haruja. And I'm talking about the cosmetic mother. Can y'all see that? Can y'all see that picture of the Holy Grail? Of the G-spot? Okay, this picture here is showing a picture of the placenta. The placenta, okay. I suggest all male women that's having children right now, to get that placenta. Take that home with you. Don't let them have that. Okay. Start taking that placenta, male women. All right. Start getting all your melon back, everything, all that melon. Get all your properties back. Get all your stuff back. Okay. And that's what that represents. So if y'all look at the placenta, y'all notice that it's called the tree of life. If you look inside of the placenta, you will see the roots coming out of it. You will see how you see this placenta? Let me bring y'all closer so y'all can see this placenta. That's inside of a womb of a mother. Y'all see that placenta? Y'all see that looking just like the tree? Look just like the tree of life. Y'all see this? You see this picture? This picture represents, this is what it looked like inside of the womb. All male babies are female first inside of the womb. All male babies are females first inside of the womb, my YouTube family. They, this how is this shape inside of your mother's womb. And, so this, if it's gonna be a male, it will come out to be a penis. All right, your balls, male and man, or your ovaries. All right, fam, don't get mad at me about the information, baby. I'm just trying to get the information out, my family. And that's not putting the saying that the man is higher than the woman. We just get ready to put the male and woman back in her proper place. Okay, family, that's what Ty get ready to do tonight. And show y'all how she is the creator of life, your mother, Your mother is your creator of life. Not, we didn't come from a rib of a nobody, no man at all. I don't care what color you want to put it, okay? We still didn't come from a rib of a man. So, so even in, there's, okay, I got some scriptures that you all can look up in your Bible, so you can all see how the male and woman is the creator of life, even in the Bible. Okay, like in when you read the word, like well, we, if you go to Corinthians 11 and 3, you'll read that, how about the, like the woman should be silent. It'll start off saying that the woman is silent, being silent. And then when you go on to, I got a lot of scriptures y'all can go to. Corinthians 11 and 3, Corinthians 14 and 34, Timothy 2 and 12, Genesis 3 and 16. Okay, so, and when you read in when you read in Genesis, you will see that the children that the women have will rule over you, and it be specific about the word. Because it says sons down there. When you read sons, it's talking about a son. They being specific about that our male children will rule over the mother. Okay? Like it is going on today. Still. It's going. It's been like that. Okay. When you use the word, the name Hawa in Hebrew. Okay. The word Hawa means mother of all living. Okay. And so, when you read about the mother of all living, they're talking about Hawa. And Hawa was what y'all would call Eve, okay? Eve is Hawa in Hebrew, okay? And the word Selah, like when the word Selah in Hebrew means rib or side. So, when you read in the Bible about the rib and the side, that was Nefertari giving surgery to Enki. He said, "Oh, Nefertari, my side, my rib, Empress, you know her. He needed fixed." So, if you look on the walls of Kemetic, you'll see the where they had the operating table, and you'll see Nefertari giving surgery to Enki. Okay, and Enki is Asar. Asar is Ray. Ray is Ra. Ra is, you know, the sun. We're talking about a sun deity. We're not talking human form right now. So when you're doing this, you have to like come inside of the cosmos, inside of nature, and then you gotta come. And spirit, breath, breathe, you know, wind, shoot, okay? So as you doing that, you got to come that, and then you got to come flesh. So you got to come in and out and weigh both of them to come in and out to be flesh. And most people call it spiritual. So you got to come spiritual and back to flesh, okay, when you doing this, family. So y'all can see with your third eye, okay, babe. Y'all got to start seeing with your third eye. You got to start seeing this one, okay, that one. So, if the word Selah means rib or side, family, that's what the word means in Hebrew, rib or side. Don't forget that. Don't forget that, family, that I said that. The word T spelled T-I, means rib, okay, or side. Same thing. The word T means rib or side. The word Selah means side or rib. Don't forget, Phil, because I'm going to ask y'all later. The word he means teeth. The word he means teeth. See, where you going with this, Ty? Where you trying to go with this, Ty? The word yah mean head. Did y'all get that? The word yah mean hand. Mean a hand. Y'all don't get it, do ya? Y'all don't get this. So far, we know that Selah and T means rib or side. We know the word he means teeth. We know the word yah means hand. She represents nipple, knob. Y'all don't hear me though. Y'all don't hear Ty. You know what? The only substance you can get that kept you alive for 3 months after you came out that womb with your mother, after them 9 months you came out that womb, she had to keep you alive, didn't she? Didn't you have to stay alive? How did you stay alive? How you stay living for three months at least till you start growing them teeth? Till your hands got where you can grab. Where you can grab. What I'm talking about, fam. Anytime you see teeth, a knob, and a hand, is when breastfeeding. All right? So we know that, family. So, I wonder, who can do this? What God do that? What God or goddess y'all want to talk about that does this? Let's do some real life stuff. Let's do real life. All right? Let's represent real life. Who does that? How you get here? Did she have to do that? Huh? I just want to know. Y'all see that placenta? Y'all see it shaped just like a tree of life? Y'all see that's going up to the... Feeding her? Feeding the baby? Huh? Don't you know that's how you ate? Out of the womb of your mother? Hmm? You see that? That's the tree that multiplied, wasn't it? Didn't the Bible say multiply? Out of what? What you gonna multiply out of? How all y'all get here? How y'all get down here on earth? I just want to know. I guess it won't skip to no more pictures. I guess I gotta go and get another file. But yeah, so we know now, family, we know that the word Hebrew, in Hebrew, the word teeth, he means teeth. Yah means hand. She represents the nipple, the booby, the dot knob, or the breast, whatever y'all want to call it, the life source that kept you alive. Did y'all know that? Did y'all know all that, family? Well, y'all didn't know. I just want to know. That's because that's the only one have this substance in that milk. Something that just make us smart. That milk. Not Eximil, not Similac with iron. No, you can't be drinking Similac with iron, giving our babies no Similac with iron. Mama was breastfeeding, baby. What we have here, what do we have here, family? This say before, after, way after, what does he do? You see a set? You see Haru? You see the black Donna, mama, black mama, melon, Donna, and child? You see the Mary and Jesus? You see the Pope, and you see who he kissing? You see what he do? Can y'all see that? Y'all see what he do? He kissing the black mother and child. You know that's what they do, y'all. And then you notice in this picture that a set right here, you see her breastfeeding Haru. Why Mary not breastfeeding Jesus? People, come on, people. Why Mary not breastfeeding Jesus? Huh? Why Mary not breastfeeding Jesus? Can somebody please tell Ty? Because I want to know. Well, if you don't know, let me tell you. Let me sit this phone back down. If you don't know, let Ty tell you why. Because the European woman the European woman, or whoever, whatever kind of race y'all want to call these people, okay, the melon woman is made so different than her. She can't breastfeed. She don't have no melon. She don't have no melon. She has to get a pill from the doctor to breastfeed her babies. Why y'all think? You always see these pictures of a melon woman holding these other people's babies on their breasts to breastfeed their babies. Ain't that so? Well, why my ancestors had to feed their babies? If this was so true, why they had to feed their babies? Because I be confused sometimes, y'all. Yes, I did. You already know that. You said through that Stargate. You already know. You already know I can't do that game. They're gonna have to put you at a percentage. Oh, wait. Now, who really do that? Ooh, wait. That's that Jesus they was talking about on that cross. That's that womb man. That's that womb man. That's a womb man. Now, as you see here, this is in stone. You got the black golden legs coming down. You got her legs spread it up. And this reading in the Netter about the woman. Okay, the Netter. This sun is the sun disk for giving birth. That representing birth. You will see a G-spot in here. You'll see a G-spot right here representing the gate. That stargate. Representing that stargate that you was talking about. That's that stargate you was talking about. I recommend you melon women start having your babies in the water. That's telling about how the penis is formed out inside of the womb of the mother. That's the yoni. You see the Y. Okay. You see the pyramid. You see the eye. You see the horseshoe. The horseshoe. You see the eye. Everything you see, everything you touch got the eye of Haru on it. And that's talking about the vagina. Okay. You the only one watching me on Facebook, baby. Why don't you go over there on my YouTube page and subscribe to my page and push that bell over there that you want all type stuff, because that's where I'm gonna start going over there and teaching. I'm trying to learn how to work this thing, baby, because I'll be all up. You see me all up in the camera, baby. I'm all up in the camera. Yeah. I forgot about y'all YouTube. I'm so used to Facebook. I'm so used to talking to Facebook family. But I got to start learning how to do this. But I'm going to get off here, baby, because I'm kind of a little sleepy now. I'm kind of a little sleepy. I should have done Cosmo Kid. That's what I'm going to do. You know what? I'm going to set up here and do Cosmo Kid. I like doing Cosmo Kid. Let me do a Cosmo Kid. I'm going to play about 4 songs, baby. Then I'm going to just go on. So, you come back and see me, L. You come back now. You hear, L. You hear me. Thank y'all for listening to Ty. And I'm going to get better at this, family. I'm just a little tired right now. A little tired. I got to go lay down, baby. I got to go rest. I'm on a different time than y'all, baby. It's about 10, 11 o'clock here. It's going on about 11 o'clock here, baby. You know I gotta go lay down. But I'm gonna tune in to whoever on YouTube, baby. I'm gonna tune in, baby. But no, baby, I'll go, baby, because I'm tired. Say no, I'm gonna come back on. I'm gonna come back on. Because I feel like giving out an unk again tonight. So I'll be back on. Let me line up a little bit of music, baby. Is something you want me to play for you, L? The people come in if I do Cosmo Kid. They don't like me when I'm trying to teach. they don't like that part. Thank you for the love, L.